Hello, people. I'm Ginny Metheral. I am a fourth generation witch of Irish descent, and I practice traditional witchcraft in the wilds of Devon. Today's video is part of a new mini-series I'm doing, and this is about the elements. Now, what, may you ask, are the elements? Well, if you don't know, they are the earth, the air, fire, and water. And because I'm spending so much time at the moment poking around with my wood burner, piling up logs, creating fires, I thought we would look at the element of fire. So what we're going to do is talk about traditional fire uses in witchery, and I'm going to give you three simple fire spells using the three different elements of the fire for you to try and incorporate into your everyday witchcraft. Just before we get into this video, I wanted to introduce you to this, my new space. I'm in the hayloft above the stables, which we have sort of done up, not really. It is the place where the children have their sleepovers, but it's a bit cold at the moment, so the children don't have sleepovers here. I thought I'd show you around. It's got a lovely swinging chair and a very beautiful hammock. It's got the children's bookcase. It's not that they read those books anymore. And it's also got the obligatory stained sofa. That's what you have in attics, isn't it? And this, an armchair. I hope you like my new witchy space. It is quite cold, but quite nice. And at least I'm away from my family and they can't disturb me, because normally they rush about going, "Pet Mama, I want some food." All I seem to do is ever feed my family. They've got to that stage where they just eat. They literally just eat. I do washing and cooking. Now, fire and witches go really very hand in glove. Every witch's Sabbath, every Sabbath, it's always celebrated with a bonfire. And one of the reasons I want to bring in fire as the first of this new mini series is because it's so portable. Here, I have some fire. It is traditional at fire Sabbaths for witches to leap and prance through the flames of a bonfire. Now, I don't want to do that because it looks a bit dangerous and not very nice. But I'm quite happy to leap over this and prance around this. And it's something that you can have wherever you are. A tea light costs pennies and you can do so much with it. Fire worship is something that's happened in every single culture. It doesn't matter where they were, from Aboriginal to Incan to Aztec to ancient Chinese. The traditional fire aspects, as I said, are three. Now, a fire itself is considered very cleansing. Think of forest fires, and they denude the floor of the forest of all the undergrowth, and this enables the trees that are there to grow bigger and stronger. It also exposes all the hidey holes of the little shrews and voles, etc., etc., so that the flying raptors can get to their food. It's purifying, it's cleansing, and this can be used, obviously, in witchcraft. So we're going to look at three spells today, using each of the three aspects of fire. And this is the fire itself, its smoke, and its ash. Each of these aspects has cleansing and purification properties. And so the first one we're going to look at is smoke. One of the great uses for a witch is smoke. What witch would not be without their smudge stick? This is one of my favourites. I mean, it's a bit old, it's a bit falling apart, as you can see. It's an old white sage one that I bought, which is sort of a general use smudge stick, so to speak, and it produces a great smudge. If I can breathe. So this is spell number one. So I'm going to use this smudge stick to smudge my aura. This will push out any negative influences from my aura. And if my aura is damaged in any way, which auras do get, you know, the vagaries of life hit you and your aura does become damaged, but it does heal itself. And a smudge stick will help that. So I'm going to smudge around my aura. And I'm going to take it around my head and around my hands, around my legs and around my body. This is very good for mindfulness. So if you're about to do any meditation or any calming spells, then I would always recommend a quick smudge just to clear out all the negativity from your aura. As a coven member, it's something that we often do to each other. Before we start our meetings, we'll all have a quick smudge. Just get rid of anything that we might have bought in, which is not really that useful or helpful to our coven meeting. And this is a spell that you can do on a daily basis. Before you do any witchcraft, give yourself a quick smudge, smudge out your aura, get rid of any negativity, and ensure that any damaged part of your aura is able, therefore, to regenerate and heal. So the second spell we're going to use uses the actual flame, and this is a spell using a candle. Now, I've currently in here got a purple candle. Purple is a great colour of higher thinking. It is a colour that emboldens and helps you move through the day-to-day to get to the ethereal. So you can use whatever candle colour you find most effective in this, which is a wish magic spell. Now, wish magic has been used by absolutely everybody. Phoenicians, Mesopotamians, ancient Chinese, Mongolians, Aztecs, Incas, Aborigines. Literally everyone uses wish magic. In the UK, pretty much everybody has a birthday cake on their birthday. And this is set with candles. And you blow out the candles and make a wish. Now, if that's not wish magic, I'll eat my hat again. This spell is my candle wish spell.
You will need to take a piece of paper and write upon it your wish. Now, this wish must be pertinent to yourself and nobody else, because that's how wish magic works. So I'm wishing for 100,000 subscribers. Perfect. Now it's time to light your candle, and it is at this point that you can dedicate it to any deity that you might be in contact with. I don't worship deities, and that's a whole nother video, but your deities need to know if you are dedicating this spell to them, and calling them out by name is how you will do this. Now take your piece of paper and fold it up. Make sure you've got water and a heatproof bowl to receive the burning paper available. Using the candle, burn the piece of paper, and whilst it is burning, imagine that its smoke and flames are pushing your wish out into the universe or to your deity so that they can grant your wish and make sure that its fulfillment comes true.
Finally, the last spell in this My Fire Element series is, of course, using the ash. And this last spell is a prosperity and protection spell. The prosperity comes from the use of the ash, which has got so much nutrients and from which plants and seeds can grow and sprout and life can be brought forth. The protection comes from the fire that we're going to use to make the ash. It's a great simple spell. It's quite esoteric. There's a lot going on. We're using earth, air, fire and water, all four elements in this, my final spell.
Take a piece of paper and upon it draw a symbol of prosperity. I'm going to draw a scarab beetle because I really like them, but you might prefer something like a lucky frog or the traditional pig, or maybe even a black cat, depending on what you feel. Your prosperity sigil is whatever you like and you are drawn to. The next part of the spell is to burn your sigil, ensuring that you've got a heatproof bowl on hand and some water just in case of accidents. So now we are left with the ash from the sigil that we have burnt, and I would like you to take a little bit of moon water and mix it with the ash. This has the added benefit of putting out any embers that may be still glowing, and also adding a little bit of moon magic into this spell. I'm just using a paintbrush to mix it up, as you can see, into a paste so that I can use it as an ink to draw my next sigil. The next thing to do is to take a clean piece of paper and, using the paste that you have made of the ashes with a paintbrush, draw your next sigil. I'm just drawing the Eye of Horus, which is a great protection sigil, having been used for generations of people and thousands of years. But you can use whatever sigil you prefer, or the Eye of Horus, like myself. Now, I'm no artist, so you'll have to forgive my artistic interpretation, as it's not very good. waft it around in the air to dry it, and then fold it up and put it somewhere safe. This is a talisman of protection and prosperity.
The three spells you can use at any point. There is no better or worse time to use them throughout a month. They can be done whenever you feel the need or the requirement to do so. I do hope you liked this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give me a lovely thumbs up and a bit of a subscribe, and watch out for the next three elements in this, my little mini series. And I'll see you in my next video.